Jesus, the Son of God, we have the supreme high priest who has gone through to the highest heaven. We must never let go of the faith that we have professed. For it is not as if we had a high priest who was incapable of feeling our weaknesses with us, but we have one who has been tempted in every way that we are, though he is without sin. Let us be confident, then, in approaching the throne of grace, that we shall have mercy from him and find grace when we are in need of help. Every high priest has been taken out of mankind and is appointed to act for men in their relations with God, to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins, so that he can sympathize with those who are ignorant or uncertain, because he too lives in the limitations of weakness. That is why he has to make sin offerings for himself as well as for the people. No one takes this honor on himself, but each one is called by God, as Aaron was. Nor did Christ give himself the glory of becoming high priest, but he had it through the one who said to him, "You are my son. Today I have become your father." And in another text, "You are a priest of the order of Melchizedek, and forever." During his life on earth, he offered up prayer and entreaty, aloud and in silent tears, to the one who had the power to save him out of death. And he submitted so humbly that his prayer was heard. Although he was son, he learned to obey through suffering. But having been made perfect, he became for all who obey him the source of eternal salvation, and was acclaimed by God with the title of High Priest of the Order of Melchizedek.
Enabled, he was slain in Jacob, exile, in Joseph, soul, in Moses, exposed to die. He was sacrificed in the Passover lamb, persecuted in David, dishonored in the prophets. It is he who was made man of the Virgin, he who was hung on the tree. It is he who was buried in the earth, raised from the dead, and taken up to the heights of heaven. He is the mute lamb, the slain lamb, the lamb born of Mary, the fair ewe. He was seized from the flock, dragged off to be slaughtered, sacrificed in the evening and buried at night. On the tree, no bone of his was broken. In the earth, his body knew no decay. He is the one who rose from the dead and who raised man from the depths of the tomb.
Come here.
to bring a great many of his sons into glory, it was appropriate that God, for whom everything exists and through whom everything exists, should make perfect through suffering the leader who would take them to their salvation.
Father anointed Christ with the Holy Spirit to proclaim forgiveness to those in bondage. Let us call humbly upon the eternal priest, Lord, have mercy on us. You went up to Jerusalem to suffer and so enter into your glory. Bring your church to the Passover feast of heaven. Lord, have mercy on us. You were lifted high on the cross and pierced by the soldier's lance. Heal our wounds. Lord, have mercy on us. You made the cross the tree of life. Give its fruit to those who are born in baptism. Lord, have mercy on us. On the cross you forgave the repentant thief. Forgive us our sins. Lord, have mercy on us. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Let us pray. God of infinite compassion, to love you is to be made holy. Fill our hearts with your love. By the death of your Son, you have given us hope, born of faith. By his rising again, fulfill this hope in the perfect love of heaven, where he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
I will be your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Benedicamus Domino Deo.